In an article written by Grace Turney for Showbiz Cheat Seats, singer Amy Winehouse was known for her unique, powerful voice and vulnerable lyrics. She was also known for her drug and alcohol addictions, which fans watched her battle for years. Winehouse died in 2011, joining the famed 27 Club, a group of celebrities who died at age 27. She was found in her apartment in London with a blood alcohol content of 416 milligrams per 100 milliliters, more than five times the legal drink drive limit. Winehouse's doctor, Dr. Christina Romete, described the singer as single-minded and intelligent. She said that Winehouse repeatedly refused psychiatric help because she felt it would stifle her creativity. Romete saw Winehouse the night before she died when she had been drinking. The doctor said when she asked Winehouse if she was going to stop drinking, she said that she didn't know. Though concerned about Winehouse's alcohol abuse, Romete was not worried about a risk of suicide because the singer specifically said she did not want to die. A second inquest in 2013 confirmed that Winehouse's cause of death was an accidental alcohol overdose. Years prior, Fleetwood Mac star Stevie Nicks publicly offered the singer a piece of advice that seemingly predicted Winehouse's tragic death. In 2008, 3 years before Amy Winehouse died, Stevie Nicks opened up to Q Magazine about the one piece of advice she would give the singer. Nicks, who called Winehouse very talented, opined that the singer had the chance to have a great career before adding, "I would say to her, you won't have it, you'll become a miserable drug addict and you'll die most likely and the record company will drop you and go on to the next person waiting in the wings and not doing coke that wants to be a star." The Fleetwood Mac singer's advice to Amy Winehouse came from experience. Stevie Nicks has been open about her own history of drug abuse. After discovering Nicks had burned a hole the size of a coin through her nose from cocaine use, a plastic surgeon warned the singer she could lose her nose or die. She didn't quit the drug. Nicks checked herself into the Betty Ford Center for 30 days to overcome her cocaine addiction, a move that likely saved both her career and her life.